Hey, Veronica. Hi, Donovan. My, he's getting big. How old is he?
He just turned 5.
Oh, wow, he's such a big boy. Yay. Hey, you know, breastfeeding on the schedule must be a real hassle. I remember I used to express my milk into a bottle. Made my life so much easier.
Is there a problem, Lynette?
The people in this office feel a little concerned that you're nursing a boy of Donovan's age.
Do they know breast milk boosts the immune system? It's loaded with vitamins, and in the third world, it's not unusual to nurse babies up to the age of 6.
Yeah, well, in the third world, they don't have juice boxes.
This is Donovan's decision. He will tell me when he's ready to stop nursing.
Come on. Baby birds don't jump out of the nest. They need to be pushed.
Did you also know that breast milk is thought to raise IQ scores? Yeah. Maybe if you'd weaned your kids a bit later, they'd be more civilized.
Ouch.
I will not be judged by you or anyone else, and if people don't like my breastfeeding, they can talk to my lawyer.
Your husband's overseas, Paula?
Ass deep in the Sunni Triangle.
Not exactly a garden spot.
Desert air must appeal to him. He keeps re-enlisting.
Lonely nights.
I keep busy.
Like with Jeff Taylor?
Me and Jeff might have had a thing.
A thing? Like an affair?
No, we'd get together and do crosswords.
And Dana being your friend didn't count for much.
Wartime. Rules change.
So you and Jeff are hitting it. Then Dana comes home and he starts flying right. You're out in the cold.
Well, you know the old saying about the woman scorned.
Except I wasn't.
The affair kept going?
Jeff was patient, but a month after she came home, Dana still wouldn't let him touch her.
So pretty soon, he's back in your arms.
And then it all blew up. You probably think I'm some bimbo homewrecker.
Pretty much.
He was lonely, so was I.
And then Dana cleared the way for you.
Once she busted us, it was over.
Over for her, too. She disappeared that night, leaving Jeff kind of single.
Like I said, that was the end of him and me. But no worries. I've got a new Jody now.
Oh, congratulations.
You can go, Paula.
I'm a concerned citizen about the number of visitors you receive.
Is that a crime?
Well, it is if you're turning tricks.
Oh, that's ridiculous. I'm married. I have 2 kids in grade school. Why on earth would I
ever... So you're not turning tricks at home while your husband's at the office and your boys are going to school?
No. No, absolutely not.
Now, how do you explain these gentlemen?
I have a lot of friends.
Yeah, well, you sure are friendly. I'll give you that.
Mrs. Cook, please just give us a reasonable explanation for what's going on here, and we'll drop this whole matter.
What do you want from me?
We want what you're doing to stop. That's it. We're not looking to ruin anyone's life here, but your neighbors don't want to live next door to the chicken ranch.
You can't arrest me. In Indiana, you have to solicit an undercover cop to be prosecuted, and money has to exchange hands. So if you don't mind, I have to go pick up my son.
How does your husband feel about you entertaining so many friends? I have his number right here. Why don't I give him a call?
Please, don't contact him. He just started at this new job. Look, he got laid off for 6 months, and we got behind on our mortgage. I was only gonna do it until he got his bonus and we could catch up on the payments.
So how long have you been turning tricks?
It's a month or so. Terry said we'd be okay if we didn't solicit a cop and if we didn't handle the money.
Who's Terry? Was it Terry who did all this research on solicitation and the technicalities of the law?
I can't tell you that.
Is Terry the one who got you into this?
I can't talk about
it. Are there other women involved in this?
please, please. Don't call my husband. He'd die a thousand deaths if he knew. Please, he can't find out my cut. What if my kids find out?
Calm down. It's okay.
Am I going to be arrested? Am I going to jail?
Not if you tell us the truth.
And if I do, will you promise not to tell my husband?
I think that can be arranged.
You think or you promise?
I'm...
married. For a while now, and no other women, so far. I just knew you'd be safe.
Safe?
Sexually.
Ah. I couldn't, with anyone else, that is, I couldn't be...
serious.
Yeah, exactly.
Who's serious? I had a little liquor drink to get me up, which I overdid, and now it's got me down.
Look, you're gonna get fired or something. What you need is some strong black coffee.
No, no. On the closet door there, hanging the green bag. Reach way down inside.
There's just laundry in here.
Reach way down inside. There's a shoe. Do you feel a shoe?
Yeah.
Pull out the shoe.
Give it to me.
Thank you, sweetheart. Do you want a little pick-me-up?
Oh, no, thanks.
I may do a little bump in a time of need, but I am in no way habituated. This is not a, not a regular thing with me. Thank you, sweetheart.
You don't have to thank me. I'd do anything for you.
Would you quit this business?
Why? I want to be just like you.
Let me tell you something. You may think this is a glamorous business. And it may look like a glamorous business. Oh, crap. I need tissue. Oh. You won't tell Larry about this, will you? He's developed a judgmental streak in his twilight years. I'm here with the tissue.
The gun, he's just a kid.
So you know he's alone?
Let me see that key. Freeze, police!
Bathroom clear.
Nothing.
I told you, he paid cash for two nights only.
Any idea where they went?
No, but he bought a few maps, New York, New Jersey, Maryland.
It's the route to D.C.
But I can't imagine they got too far. The boy, he didn't look good at all.
You see now why I try not to make guarantees to the mothers of missing children?